I want to see women rise and I want to see women strong.
When will women be seen as equal?
Women have been fighting back and telling men no for the beginning of time.
We need to, as feminists, totally just mash up the system.
I remember when we used to sit in a government yard.
You treat me just like you treated the ground. You trample me all over. But I'll get on my feet again, ride on a wave to happiness. In times like these where survival is the game, let's play on.
Let's play on.
By the hands of the Almighty.
We're forward in this generation, triumphantly.
With Bob Marley, I had no vision when I met him at Studio One that I would have ended up working with Bob. Because when I met Bob, he was so serious. Everything that they did and what they sang were just the voice of the people. So eventually, I was doing some performances, solo performances, and I invited Judy and Rita to come and do some harmonies. And the rest is history.
Well, the harmony didn't change because then Bob took hold of the I-3s because he still wanted to maintain that sound.
Bob invited us to do the Natty Dread tour.
From the very first show, it was just dynamite.
I definitely heard Bob Marley's voice in the house, probably more than my own dad.
One, take two.
But I remember growing up and on Sunday mornings for a lot of African Caribbean households, that is time to clean, just singing along to his words, Three Little Birds. It was just a really good pick-me-up and what sometimes felt like really hard times.
Like every song of his is still relevant. Even the love songs are still relevant.
No woman, no cry. No woman, no cry.
Things that happen, you know, politically, and things that happen in the social world, and the real life things, and the spiritual things. And I take the spiritual things more than the political and the other stuff, but all of his messages still stand.
I remember
when we used to sit in a government yard in Trenchtown. That's a serious thing for him to go to that place where he humbles himself enough to be like, you're not going through this alone, because I remember.
I personally know my heart can be hard as a stone and yet soft as water.
In the song No Woman No Cry, you know, it is, it's a painful song, but it's also a song that is supposed to comfort women.
There's lyrics that come to mind sometimes in my work that provide real comfort, and there's sometimes where I use these lyrics to kind of challenge our community to demand more from society as well.
Well, the primary message of Bob Marley, I think all of us would agree, is emancipation. Just rebellion against systems of oppression. And that would include patriarchy, Marley's lyrics, get up, stand up. All of that fighting for rights could be seen as part of a legacy of empowerment for women.
There's no weapon on earth that is as powerful as music.
How do you think the music audience from those days to now, how do you think things change, and how do you think Bob's story or legacy from those days to now?
It changed my life. And what your dad wrote in his music is so important today, even more important today maybe than it was then.
It was not until I started working with Bob and I saw how serious this man took his music. The music was his life. That's when I started thinking about the message that I'm sending in my songs. Bob opened my eyes to that.
We're remaining but a fleeting illusion to be pursued, but never attained. Well, everywhere is war.
When did you get the job? Are you going to shoot Bob Marley?
1975, when we did music press interviews in West Hollywood. I kind of set up the chairs so that Bob would be in a place where the light would be beautiful. And and then he didn't mind me shooting at will. You know, he didn't like to pose, but he didn't mind me just being a fly on the wall and just shooting whatever was going on. This was between the interviews. It was just a wonderful experience to be around him. And
well, what do you feel like? I want to be, you know, around him for those years and see who he was and, like, now, how you feel?
Well, he's revered all over the world.
Yeah.
And the message hits home for people. They understand that vision of people coming together and standing up for justice and taking care of each
other. Like, in that time, did you think, was he just like, how do you feel about him as an artist, or what he was doing, and do you think he was going to get bigger and bigger and bigger? And
well, we certainly hope so. We wanted to get the message out.
Okay.
And he was so charismatic that people were drawn to him and drawn to the music and drawn to the message. And it was very exciting to be part of that process.
I got a letter from Bonnie, bringing a letter. He was even sending his letter to his friend, not by himself, and to say, yes, he likes me and want to talk to me. Said, come over and talk. And he would stay on the other side of the road. He was very shy. More than a shy guy.
I'll play your favorite song, darling.
He had a seriousness. And he was one that you could see was reaching out for love.
Don't rock my boat.
It was amazing to see how Bob was just loved by the people and how people gravitated to his work. And he said in one of his songs that music is going to teach them a lesson.
Oh, 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 oh.
But I do remember having the lyrics to Buffalo Soldier in my head when I was younger and thinking, my goodness, this is African American history. This is actually African American history in these lyrics.
We grew up in a loving family and with a lot of respect because our father, stern man, and Mama Rita always kept us in line, you know, because we have different mothers, you know, but it doesn't matter. We consider Mama Rita the matriarch of the family.
I became his guardian angel.
I realized that he wasn't just a man or a husband for her. She truly saw him as a prophet, as an angel on earth.
I was the one that he would call to get women out of his dressing room, and get to that stage, call my phone, my room, come and get these people out for me. And I would do that gracefully. Come on, ladies, it's bedtime.
I decided I wanted to express myself and the kind of songs that I wanted to sing, because when I look at slavery and I see the degradation and I see the pain that my mothers and my foremothers suffer, the Black Woman album came forth out of all of that experience.
Black woman, ooh, black woman, like me you've struggled long. Your trod one of life's roughest road, and with the heaviest load. To be someone to belong, but you're nearing a mile and a half furlong. Don't give up now, just pray for strength now, for you are
So representation is critical because it gives you confidence, right? Some people are born with that inner feeling that they can be the first, that they can be the one to break down the barriers, that they have that kind of wherewithal. Not everyone does, right? And so for all of the rest of us who need to have that positive motivating force coming from outside, we need that representation.
All of those background singers had the potential to be frontline singers. Master Griffiths, Judy Moore, you know, had to fight to become visible. It was an important moment for other women to see that, yes, these women are on the world stage, we can do it too.
When you release a song, it will go sometimes where you will never be able to go. It goes ahead of you.
I feel your reflection, for you are dedicated my song.
We just played that record today. Can't actually remember anything else we played apart from Judy Moat. It was the first time that we were really able to say, this is what we're about, this is what we believe we should be doing as black women. It was affirming the things that we were campaigning and organizing around, and it was hugely empowering.
One love, one heart, let's get together and feel all right.
Every night, there would be rehearsal at 56 Hope Road for the concert.
We usually had two guys from equivalent to the Secret Service. They call them the Protective Service. They like protect the Prime Minister and stuff. And they used to come every night, but they never came that night.
While I was in the car now getting ready to come out, I see some men going up the steps.
The gunman approached from the side here and kind of pushed his gun through here.
Then they turned the gun on the car. I felt the warmth, the blood running down. Then I realized I was shot.
I remember growing up and seeing so many injustices in my community, but what probably activated me the most was when my friend Charlotte was stabbed and murdered at a house party when I was 15. That anger for Charlotte's death was channeled into wanting to be a positive force in politics.
So you guys mentioned very good ideas, and like you mentioned, they are temporary. My idea of a long-term solution, which is for the EU.
I quickly realized decisions were being made about my local community and my area and people who looked like me, but we were not at all in a decision-making room, on the table, even being consulted. And so I really wanted to use my platform when I was elected to try and change the game. I didn't know what that meant. I didn't know what the steps were. I didn't have the cultural capital, didn't have the networks that a lot of my counterparts in politics have. As you get more woke, I guess is this, that's the word, you realize how unfair things are. The first commissions that I pushed for when I got onto the council was around domestic violence.
Get up, stand up. Stand up for your rights.
Unless you fight, you just give in. So the alternative is not to give in. It's to constantly sing these songs of freedom. It's constantly try to express this vision, this redemptive vision of possibilities. You can't limit yourself to what is.
I'm super excited about movements that are going on around the world.
One of the big issues that women are now fighting against in Jamaica is the decriminalization of termination of pregnancy. We want more women to be able to claim reproductive rights.
I want people to make no assumptions on the body that stands in front of them.
We want to see a change, not only for women and men, but for the future generation.
We'll share a shelter. My single bed, we'll share the same room. To provide the bread. Is this love that I'm feeling? Is this love that I'm
Bob was like a stranger throwing a rope. Like a rope in that hole, being like, nah, you can come out. You can't put on a Bob Marley song and not feel that it's like a, it's this happiness frequency that just comes and it hits you, and nobody's gonna tell you different, because it's like, it can make a fucking plant dance.
We have to join with other women and create a kind of network of sisterhood that allows all women to feel that they can stand up to the forces of patriarchy. It's about the ideology. What are you bringing as a woman to this discourse?
So dry your tears, I say. Everything's gonna be alright.